Hi, in this video we are going to learn how relationship between two models are done. So in previous video we have already done the users model and we have written all the methods, static methods of user model, and I am added one more model in here, that is a task model. In here the user have the task, so the user can can create a task for them. So this is the task model, and I have created this project in a systematic way. That is, this is a folder of models, and in here two files are there, task model and user model, and I have also separated the connection. So this is the DB model, DB folder. In here that is the middleware folder, and here is the router, the thing that we have learned about Mini Express. So in here we are just like in here we are not written like the app Express. We have written the router, which we get from Express or router, and we just export it, module.export equal to router. The same thing we have done for the task router also. In here the router of task means task router have some API endpoints, that is creating a task, getting the task by ID, updating the task, deleting a task by ID. So we have exported it also. And in here the main file, that is index.js, we are just importing it from these two files, and we are using app.use, user router, and task router. That's it. So now in here we are going to learn how can we relate these two, task and user model, to each other. So if a task is being created, so the task is being created by an owner. That means an owner means a user. We have to create the owner field in here. And in owner field, the type will be the ID of the user. So the type will be that we get from the mongoose dot schema dot types dot object ID. It is also required, so we can give true, and yeah, that's it. Now if we go to our task router in here. In here we have to when we are creating a task, we have also to authenticate that the task is being created by a user, that is being logged in. So for that we have also imported the out, and just we have to write in here out means if it is authenticate, if the endpoint is being authenticated, this task can be created in here. So in here this is going to be, this is the spread out operator. So all the fields that are in here requested body is going to spread out, and in here we are going to just write the field owner. And we can get the request.user.id. Yeah, that's it. Now if we save it and go to our Postman, and for now I have created, I am going to log in with this Alex user. I haven't run the localhost 3000. So I'm going to run it. So we just have to write like notmon, or we can just simply write npm run dev. Now it's running. Now if we go to the postman, and again we logged in with, okay, sorry, logged in with, so we are going to log in with this user. So now if we logged in, we can get the token. Now for creating a task, we are going to go to the create task, and authorization is needed here. We are just going to create authorization. Bearer the token value and the body. So in body we are going to just create like the JSON file is needed. So we are going to see what's in the task.js name and is completed. So name, let's say Node.js course, and is completed. This is not right. We have to write like a JSON format. Yeah, this is right. It's completed. It is false, so we have to just write false. That's it. Now if we send it, we can see that the new task has been created and the owner ID is being there. So if we go to our MongoDB compass and if we refresh it, we can see new task is being created with the object ID of the Alex owner. Now if we want to like get the owner, all the description, all the information about the owner, we can do it. If we, I'm going to show into the in the index.js. So first like my function, that's how we can call this, and in here let's say const my function is an async value. And now we are just going to get the task. So we can do like first we have to like import the task model also in here. So const task is equal to require it from db slash models slash task. Yeah, so task dot find one, and we can like find by id, and the id will be this one. So from here we can get the task. So if we want to console log the task.owner, if we console it in here, we get undefined. Oh, we have to like await it from, because it's an asynchronous process. Now if we again rerun again, we can get the ID, but we don't get the whole information about the user. So for getting all the information about the user, we can do by like this. Now for creating, for getting all information about the user, we have to like give one more reference. Ref Raphael. In here, the model name is given. So the model name will be this one, users. So in here, we are just going to write users. Now, if we again run here, like await task dot populate, this is the function that we are needed here. Populate, we are going to populate the field of owner, and we are going to execute it by using execute populate. Now if we just like console it, and we can see that all the information about the owner is being written in here, everything. So yeah, that's how the we can get the we can populate any field of another user of another collection. So I'm going to comment it out from here. Now we are going to see how can a user from user model we can get the tasks. So for getting the task, I'm going to rerun the same function in here. So in here we are going to need the user model, so we are just going to acquire it from the DB model and users. And now in here we don't need this one, and also we don't need this one. So in here we are going to get the user is equal to await users dot find by ID, and we are going to use the ID of our user, that is this one. We can get it from here. Oh, just a sec. I have acquired the ID number. Now we can just console it, console.log user dot task. But we haven't made the task field. So in here in the user model, we can do simply like creating a new field, and the same thing that we have done reference. But the tasks will be more than one, so it will be an array. So there is one another thing that Mongoose gave us, that is a virtual field. That is, we are not going to write the field in the model, but we are going to create a virtual field in here. So for creating a virtual field, we are going to write user schema dot virtual and the field name that we have given there, task. And also and model here, like what it's referring to. So it is referring to the tasks.js, this one. So we are going to write tasks, and we are going to use the local field of this model, that is ID. And we are going to use the foreign field of task model, that is owner. Yeah, that's it. Now if we go to our index.js and run again. No, first we have to like await it. So we are going to await user dot populate the name tasks, and also execute it. And now if we run again, we can see that we have get user is completed false and no JS course. So that's how we can There are two methods to doing the relationship between two models. So now if we go to our tasks.js, in here the thing is already done. So in here the tasks.router, there are a few things remaining. It is because we are going to authenticate all the things in here. So in here we also use the, so to getting all the tasks we are going to use auth method here. And because the user is authenticated with, is going to get the fields. So in here find by the owner field, it is owner is to request dot user dot id. That's how can we get the task. In here also the auth method is given, but it's going to be find one. So find one, and we are going to find one by using id is to request.parents.id, and also the owner method is also needed, owner field. So request.user.id. Now in here auth method, these things will be there, but in here we are going to use the find one method also, and this is going to be id, and the same thing owner is to request dot user dot id. And yeah, that's it. We can do this by this. Now in here the delete also we can do by find one, and so I'm going to just copy it from here. And that's how we can do. Now one thing is there, that if we like delete the user from the database, so the database will be deleted from the user model also and the task model also. So for doing this we are going to use the same thing, we are going to use a pre method. So we can do this by user schema dot pre, and we are going looking for remove method and async function. And now we are just going to get use the const user is equal to this, and we also needed here the task model also, so we are just going to acquire it from const task is equal to require dot slash task. Now so we are going to await task dot find. We are going to find by owner and the id will be request.user.id, and we are going to use the next function also, and we are going to use the remove function in here. and just we are going to write the next here. So that's how we can use two models in your users and tasks. And yeah, that's how it's being done. Thank you.